So the director said most of what I meant to say, but I will repeat a few details. First of all, because I have to thank the director, because I wouldn't be able to thank himself. So we have to thank with pleasure the director, Professor Fabio Beltman, and the dean of the class of sciences, Professor Luigi Ambrosio, whose very generous support made this conference possible, especially in this not easy period. However, we are also very grateful to the many participants, chairpersons, and speakers who contributed largely to their own expenses. I want to really be precise, since an event of this size would have been unthinkable otherwise. Finally, I would like to thank, also on behalf of my colleagues, Enrico Trincherini. Please stand up. Where are you? Because because the other members of the committee know well that without Enrico, this event would have not taken shape. Now I will repeat something that the director said, but I think it's important to stress it. And when we decided with my colleague Mario Vietri, who's here, to organize a conference for Riccardo, we decided not to abide to standard practice. Standard practice is that this conference takes place at the end of the academic career, just before retirement. And for Riccardo, we didn't want it to be like that. We really chose picked a random date. The random date is chosen so that it conflicts insofar as possible little with other commitments, so we chose it just before the holidays. But the idea is precisely like the director said, to make a signpost, but we're not at the end of the story. The last comment I want to make, which is slightly different, refers to the poster. As you noticed, the poster was meant to stress how much of Riccardo's life is connected to this institute, essentially all the scientific life of Riccardo. And conversely, of course, the meeting will stress the other side of the story, which means how much this institute owes to Riccardo. And this, of course, goes in two directions. The first one is the one that the director stressed, the impact of Riccardo as a leading figure for decades. But the second point I want to stress is that Riccardo acted during these decades as a mentor of entire generations of scientists who are now occupying prestigious positions worldwide. So I think that this covers the whole story. And thank you for being here for Riccardo.